गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर 12 रेशियो एंड प्रोपोर्शन एक्सरसाइज 12.3 क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। इन क्वेश्चन 1 है, इफ द कास्ट ऑफ 7 मीटर क्लॉथ इज 1470 रुपीस, फाइंड द कास्ट ऑफ 5 मीटर क्लॉथ। So let's see how to find this question. This is given the cost of 7 meter cloth. Okay, first we write here cost of 7 meter cloth. This is given 1470 rupees. Cost of 7 meter cloth is equal to 1470 rupees. This is given, and so first you find cost of 1 meter cloth. Okay, so cost of 1 meter cloth, this is equal to we divide 1470 by 7. In this way you obtain the cost of 1 meter cloth is 210 rupees. Okay, in this question this is given that the cost of 7 meter cloth is 1400. So we find the cost of 1 meter cloth is 1470 by 7. If you divide 1470 by 7, then you obtain 210 rupees. This is clear. Now in this question to ask that find the cost of 5 meter cloth. Okay, so you can write here cost of 5 meter cloth. This is equal to what? Cost of 5 meter cloth is equal to, we have cost of 1 meter cloth is 210 rupees. So we can write here 5 into 210. Okay? Because in this question this is given that the cost of 7 meter cloth is 1470 rupees. So we find the cost of 1 meter cloth. Okay, so how can you find the cost of 1 meter cloth? If you divide 1470 by 7, then you obtain the cost of 1 meter cloth. This is equal to what? 210 rupees. But question asked to us, find the cost of 5 meter cloth. So for this, we multiply 5 by 210, because 210 is the cost of 1 meter cloth. So if you multiply this, then we obtain 5 into 0, it becomes 0. 5 into 1 is 5, and 5 into 10. So in this way, you can see here the cost of 5 meter cloth is 1050 rupees. Okay? Cost of 5 meter cloth is 1050 rupees. In this question, this is given that the cost of 7 meter cloth is 1470 rupees. We need to find cost of 5 meter cloth. So for this, first you find the cost of 1 meter cloth. How can you find cost of 1 meter cloth? If you divide 1470 by 7, because 1470 is the cost of 7 meter cloth. If you divide by 7, then you obtain 210, this is the cost of 1 meter cloth. If you multiply by 5 in 210, then you obtain cost of 5 meter cloth. So student, I hope all of you understood these questions. Now we are going to discuss question second of this exercise 12.3, question number 2. Question number 2 is Ekta earns 3000 rupees in a 10 days. Ekta earns 3000 rupees in a at 10 days, how much will she earn in 30 days? So in this question, this is given. Ekta earns 3000 rupees in 10 days. So we need to find how many she earns in 30 days. So first you find Ekta earn in 1 day. After this you find Ekta earn in 30 days. So let's see how to find it. First we write this. This is given in question number 2, Ekta earns 10 days. And this is question number 2. This is given that Ekta earns in 10 days. This is called rupees 3000. Ekta earns in 10 days. Rupees 3000. So we find the Ekta earns in 1 day. Now Ekta earns in 1 day. 1 day, this is called rupees 3000 by 10. So obviously you can see if you divide 3000 by 10, then you obtain, what you obtain? You obtain here rupees 300. Rupees 300. This is clear. Now, so here you find Ekta earned in 30 days. Ekta earned in 30 days is called 30 into 300 rupees, okay? Because Ekta earn in 1 day is 300 rupees, and this is given that Ekta earn in 10 days is 3000. So you find Ekta earn in 1 day, this is equal to 3000 by 10, this is equal to 300 rupees. So Ekta earn in 1 day is 300 rupees. So how many money earned by Ekta in 30 days? So you multiply here, you multiply 30 into 300. Okay, this is equal to what? This is equal to 3 9 1 2 3 9000 rupees. Ekta earned in 30 days is equal to 9000 rupees. Student, in this question, this is given that Ekta earns in 3000 rupees in 10 days. How much will she earn in 30 days? So first you find amount of money earned by Ekta in 1 day. So here you can see Ekta earn in 1 day is 3000 by 10. Why we divide 3000 by 10? Because Ekta earns in 10 days, money is 3000. Ekta earn 3000 money in 10 days. So we find Ekta earn in 1 day. Okay, so 3000 by 10. Now we need to find Ekta earns money in 30 days. So this amount is 300. Ekta earn in 1 day is 300. So in 30 days, how many amount she will earn in 30 days? So you can say you multiply 30 by 300. Then we have 9000 rupees. Okay, so Ekta earn in 30 days 9000 rupees. This is clear. Now we are going to discuss next questions. I hope all of you understood this question. This is question number 2. This is clear. Now in question number 3, if it has rained 276 millimeters in the last 3 days, how many centimeter of rain will be fall in full 1 week, 1 week in 7 days, and assume that the rain continue to fall at the same rates? Okay, so in this question, this is given that rains in 3 days, this is given, what is given? 276 millimeter. So let's see how to solve. this question, question number 3. First you write, rent in 3 days, this is equal to 276 meters. So you find rent 1 day. Okay, so you divide 276 by 3. Now you need to find rent in 1 week. 1 week is equal to how many days? Okay, 1 week is equal to 7 days. So we find rent, question number 3. This is given here. Rent in 3 days. How many? 276 million. Rent in 3 days. This is equal to 276 millimeters. Okay. So we find rent in 1 day. So rent in 1 day. This is equal to 276 by 3 millimeters. Okay. If you divide it, then you obtain 39 27 and 32 are 6 millimeters. Okay. So you can see here, rent in 1 day, this is equal to 92 millimeters, and we need to find rent in 1 week, 1 full week. So 1 full week, 1 week is equal to what? 7 days. Okay, 1 week is equal to 7 days. So we find the rent in 7 days. Okay. So let's see, you write here, rent in 1 week, this is equal to 92 millimeter into 7, because you know very well, 1 week is equal to 7 days, then we multiply it. Then we obtain 7 to 14, carry 1, 7, 9 to 63, 63, 1, 64, 64. So in this way you can say the rent in 7 days or rent in 1 week, this is equal to 644 days. Clear? Now, but the question asked, find how many centimeter of rain will fall in one full week. So here this is millimeter, we convert it in centimeter. So you know very well, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. So here we have 600. So you can write it 10 millimeter. This is equal to 1 centimeter or 1 millimeter. This is equal to, you can write 1 by 10 centimeters. But we have 644 millimeter. We have 644 millimeter. So 644 millimeter, this is equal to 644 by 10 centimeter, this is equal to 64.4 centimeter. Okay, ठीक है, so we can write here, this is equal to 64.4 centimeters. So student, I hope all of you understood this question. And in this question, this is given that rain in last 3 days is equal to 276 millimeters. So we find rain in last 1 day or 1 day, this is equal to 276 by 3 millimeter, this is equal to 92 millimeters. But we need to find the rain in full week. So how can find the rain in full week? If you multiply 92 by 7, because in 1 full week we have 7 days, and 90, this is a run in last one day in 92 millimeters. If we multiply by 92 by 7, then we have 644 millimeters. This is a run in 1 week, 644 millimeters. But question asked to find it in centimeter. So we know that 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters, or 10 millimeter is equal to 1 centimeter, or you can write it 1 millimeter is equal to 1/10 centimeters. So we have 64 millimeter. It means 644. We have 644 millimeter. This is equal to 644 by 10 centimeters. If we divide 644 by 10, then we have 64.4 centimeters. In this way, you can see the run in 1 full week is 64.4 centimeters. Okay, so student, I hope all of you understood this question. Now we are going to discuss next question, question number 4. Question number 4 have cast of 5 kg weight is 91.5 rupees. So what will be the cost of 8 kg of weight? So cost of 5 kg of weight is given here. So we find first cost of 1 kg of weight. After this we multiply by 8, then we have cost of 8 kg of weight. Okay, and the next question is given here. Next part of question number 4 is what quantity of weight can be purchased in 183 rupees. So let's see how to find, how to solve this question. Question number 4. In this question, this is given. What is given in this question? In this question, this is given cost of 5 kg. This is question number 4. Cost of 5 kg weight. This is equal to, what is this cost of 5 kg weight is equal to rupees 921.5. Okay, so first you find cost of 1 kg weight. This is equal to what? This is equal to 921.5 divided by 5. If you divide it, then we have 18.30. Clear? So here this is equal to cost of 1 kg weight is 18.30 rupees. Okay, same question part 1. What will be the cost of 8 kg of weight? Okay, so you can write it pointly. Cost of 1 kg weight is 18.30 rupees. So here we find cost of 8 kg weight. This is equal to 8 into 18.30. okay, if you multiply it, then we obtain 8 into 0, this is equal to 0. 8 into 3 8 is 24, carry 2, 0.8 is 64. 8 into 8 64. 64 plus 2, this is equal to 66. 68 is 64. 64 plus 2, 66, and 8 into 1 8 8 plus 6, this is equal to 14. So here you can see the cost of 8 kg is 146.40 rupees. okay, in this question this is given the cost of 5 kg is 91.50. So we find cost of 1 kg weight, this is equal to 91.5 by 5. Then we obtain 18.30 rupees. So we need to find the cost of 8 kgfeet. So cost of h kgfeet is equal to 8 × 18.3. This is equal to 146.40 rupees. Now we need to find how what quantity of wheat can be purchased in 183 rupees. Okay, so we write here B part of this question, quantity of wheat. Okay, quantity of wheat, quantity of wheat purchased in rupees 183. This is equal to, here you can see the cost of 1 kg wheat is 18.3 rupees. So we need to find how quantity of wheat we can purchase in 183 rupees. So you can divide it 183 rupees by rupees 18.30. Okay, so if you cancel it, then you obtain 10. Okay, how can you cancel it? If you multiply both numerator and denominator by 10, then you obtain rupees 1830 by rupees 183. Then you have to take. What do you have to take? Clear? So this is a amount of feet that you can purchase in 183 rupees. So student, I hope all of you understood. In this question, this is given the cost of 5 kg wheat is equal to 91.5 rupees. So first you find the cost of 1 kg wheat. This is equal to 91.5 by 5. This is equal to rupees 18.3. Now, so we need to find the cost of 8 kg wheat. So the cost of 8 kg wheat is equal to 18.30. This is equal to 146.40 rupees. Okay. Now, next part of this question is that what quantity of wheat can be purchased in 183 rupees? What quantity of wheat can be purchased in 183 rupees? So we know that cost of 1 kg wheat is equal to 18.3 rupees. So if you divide 18.3 in 183, then you obtain 10. So 10 kg we purchase in 183 rupees. So student, I hope all of you understood this question. Now we are going to discuss next question, question number 5. What have been question number 5? The temperature dropped 15 degree Celsius in last 3 days. The temperature dropped 15 degree Celsius in the last 30 days. If the rate of temperature drop remains the same, how many degrees Celsius will the temperature drop in the next 10 days? Okay, so let's see how to solve this question. First we write it in the question number 5, this is given that the temperature will drop in last 30 days in 15 degrees Celsius, and the rate of temperatures is constant, means remains the same. Every day we drop same rate. Okay, so let's see. Okay, this is question number 5. This is given temperature drop 30 days. Okay, temperature drop in last 30 days. This is equal to 50 degrees.
Okay, the rate of temperatures, the rate of drop temperatures is
constant.
Okay, constant means temperature drop every day in same rate. Okay, so this is given that the temperature drop in the last 30 days, this is equal to 15 degrees Celsius. This is a symbol of degree Celsius. Okay, this is symbol of degree Celsius, so don't be confused. Okay, the temperature, this is given, the temperature dropped in last 30 days in 15 degrees Celsius. So we find temperature drop, temperature drop in last 1 day. In last 1 day, this is equal to 15 degrees Celsius by 30. Because 30 degrees in 13 days, last 13 days, we find that temperature drop in 15 degrees Celsius. So in last 1 day, what will the temperature drop? So we can write 15 by 30. This is clear. If you cancel it, then you obtain 15 by 15, 15 by 30, 1/2 degree Celsius. Temperature drop in 1 day is 1/2 degree Celsius. So you need to find how many temperature will drop in the next 10 days. How many temperature will drop in next 10 days? So you can write here temperature drop. Temperature drop in 10 days is equal to, here you can see temperature drops in 1 day is 1/2 degree Celsius. So temperature drops in 10 days, this is equal to next 10 days, because the rate are same. This is given that the rate of temperature drop remains the same. Rate of temperature drop remains the same. So this is temperature drop in last 1 day is 1/2 degree Celsius. So you need to find temperature drop in last 10 days. Okay, so this is equal to 1/2 into 10. Cancel it. This is equal to 5 degrees Celsius. So student, I hope all of you understood this question number 5. In this question, and this is given that temperature dropped 15 degrees Celsius in the last 30 days. If the rate of temperature drop remains the same, so we need to find how much degree will the temperature drop in the next 10 days. So for this, first we find first write the temperature drop in the last 30 days. This is given 15 degrees Celsius. So we find the temperature drop in last 1 day. This is equal to 15 degrees Celsius by 30. Okay, 15 degrees Celsius by 30. So we obtain, if we divide it, 15 by 15, 15 by 30, then we obtain 1/2 degree Celsius. 1/2 degree Celsius temperature drop in 1 day. So we need to find here temperature drop in 10 days. So how we find temperature drop in 10 days? So for this, we multiply 1/2 into 10. Why multiply 1/2 into 10? Because 1/2 degree Celsius is the temperature decreased, drop in 1 day. Okay, but here we need to find temperature drop in 10 days. So 1/2 into 10, this is equal to 5 degrees Celsius. Okay, so student, I hope all of you understood this question. In this question, only this is given that the temperature drops in 30 days, in last 30 days is 15 degrees Celsius. So we find the temperature drop in 1 day is 1/2 degree Celsius. Again, the question asks to us, find the temperature drop in next 10 days. If the rate of temperature drop remains constant. So for this, we multiply 10 days 10 into 1 by 2. Why we multiply 10 into 1 by 2? Because 1 by 2 degree Celsius, temperature is drop in 1 day. So you need to find temperature drop in 10 days. So 1 by 2 into 10, this is equal to 5 degree Celsius. So student, I hope all of you understood this question. Thank you for watching. Jai Hind.